Indicated airspeed is one of the first and most important concepts that every pilot learns. It's the speed shown on the airspeed indicator in the cockpit, and it plays a critical role in everything from takeoff and landing to stall prevention and maneuvering. In today's video from Epic Flight Academy, we're breaking down what indicated airspeed really means, how it's measured, and why it's so essential to flying safely. If you're interested in becoming an aviation professional, hit that like button and subscribe to Epic Flight Academy for more expert aviation insights. Airspeed is alive.
Hi, my name is Ray Altmann, and I'm the Chief Flight Instructor at Epic Flight Academy. Indicated airspeed is what your airspeed indicator indicates. It's kind of an interesting way of saying it, but it's your pitot and your static inputs that are displayed on your airspeed indicator. It's very important to learn because most of our V-speeds are based off of the indicated airspeeds. Understanding indicated airspeed will prevent you from putting yourself in dangerous conditions, whether that's flying too slow or too fast. It will help you best utilize the aircraft's performance in the conditions that you need it. It will help you with cross-country planning and understanding time, fuel, and distance calculations. It just makes you an overall safer pilot.
So, how exactly is indicated airspeed measured? It all comes down to the aircraft's pitot-static system. As air flows into the pitot tube, it's compared to the static pressure around the plane. The difference between the two gives us dynamic pressure, which drives the airspeed indicator. What makes indicated airspeed so useful is that it reflects how the aircraft feels in the air, not just how fast it's going over the ground. That's why pilots rely on it to control the aircraft precisely, especially during takeoffs, landings, and climbs. To really understand indicated airspeed, it helps to compare it with other types of airspeed. Calibrated airspeed corrects for small instrument or position errors. True airspeed adjusts for changes in altitude and temperature. And ground speed factors in wind to show how fast you're moving over the Earth's surface. While all these serve different purposes, when it comes to real-time control in the cockpit, indicated airspeed is the number pilots trust the most. This becomes especially important when we talk about V-speeds, those critical benchmarks that guide safe operation.
V-speeds are predetermined speed where the aircraft performs based on a certain criteria. Some of those V-speeds are VR, which is rotation speed. That's your takeoff speed, roughly. You have VG, that's your best glide speed. VY, which is your best rate of climb. VX, which would be the most amount of altitude and the shortest amount of distance. VA, which is a maneuvering speed. VNO, which is normal operation speed. VFE, flap extension speed. And VNE, which is never exceed speed. Those are just some of the V speeds that many pilots will use.
These speeds are always based on indicated airspeed because it remains consistent, regardless of air density or altitude. At Epic Flight Academy, students learn to commit these numbers to memory because confidence in the cockpit starts with knowing your aircraft's performance limits. Of course, learning isn't limited to flight time. Student pilots have access to powerful tools that help reinforce these concepts, and that includes a wide range of aviation apps. While mobile apps can't measure true indicated airspeed without a pitot-static system, they're still incredibly useful for building airspeed awareness. Apps like ForeFlight Mobile are FAA approved and provide synthetic instruments and GPS-based speed data. Simulators like Infinite Flight and X-Plane Mobile offer realistic cockpit views with functional airspeed indicators. Android users can turn to Aviation, a free GPS app with basic navigation features, or explore training tools like Flight Instruments and Aviation Tools Free, which emulate the traditional six-pack layout. Just keep in mind, these tools display ground speed, not true indicated airspeed, but they're still excellent for ground training and simulation practice. Back in the cockpit, the real-world training begins. From day one at Epic, students learn how to read and respond to indicated airspeed, whether they're flying with analog gauges or digital glass cockpits.
Some smart habits of understanding and reading the airspeed indicator is understand what the airspeed tapes or the arcs mean. Just like on your car, you'll have little indicators that tell you what should or should not be done during these arcs or these airspeed tapes. So knowing what the colors mean is very important. And also not fixating on the instrument is a very important skill. If you're staring at one instrument, you're omitting other instruments, and you're also not looking outside, which can lead to even more dangerous conditions.
Ultimately, indicated airspeed isn't just a number on a dial. It's a critical guide that tells you how your aircraft is performing in real time. It shapes decisions, enhances safety, and keeps flight operations smooth and predictable. At Epic Flight Academy, we build this understanding into every phase of your training, preparing you for a successful career in aviation.
The most common mistakes that pilots make in relation to indicated airspeed is fixating on the instrument or even omitting the instrument. Sometimes students will stare at too much and then they forget to look at outside, look at other instruments, or they might not even look at it. And one of the most important times to be monitoring your airspeed is on takeoffs and landings. You don't stare at it, but you need to scan your instruments accordingly to make sure you're maintaining those safe airspeeds to prevent any dangerous conditions.
That's everything you need to know about indicated airspeed and why it plays such a vital role in every flight. We hope this helped bring clarity to one of the most important instruments in your cockpit. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more aviation content from Epic Flight Academy.